I am Sandeep Kumar Gupta. Welcome to my life page. Today I will be talking about the wildlife forensic science. And before that, let me introduce me briefly about my qualifications and things. I did my graduation from Purvanchal University in 1998 in a Zoology, Botany and Chemistry subject. And in 2002, I completed my Master in Biotechnology from Saurashtra University, Meerut campus. And then I joined a premier institute in Hyderabad known as CCMB Center for Cellular and Molecular Biology with Dr. Lalji Singh, and he was my mentor and supervisor in the CCMB. When I joined in this institute WI in 2008, after joining the institute, I registered myself for PhD and I obtained my PhD degree from this institute in conservation genetics. I joined this institute as a scientist C, and subsequently after two promotions, now I am the scientist E, which is equivalent to principal scientist in CSIR institutions, and I am the in charge of the wildlife forensic laboratory of the institute, and I am looking after all the forensic activity in the institute. So wildlife forensic science is a very new field of the forensic science, which is about two decade old science, unlike the normal forensic science, which is the century old science, where all the forensic laboratories are performing the forensic examination related to the humans. That is a species for consideration in the all forensic science laboratories. But in the wildlife forensic science, we are talking about the species involved in the Wildlife Protection Act, or they are protected under the legislation of the country. So, in our Wildlife Protection Act, there are about 15,000 species listed. Those are protected in some or the other schedules, and for Schedule 1, the protection level is higher, then the protection level decreases for Schedule 2, 3 and 4 schedules. DNA technology is a very essential ingredient for the wildlife crime analysis. So, in DNA technology, the students should aware about the different type of DNA markers used in the different situations of the crime investigation. Like if someone want to do the individual level identification, then what type of marker is suitable? If someone want to do the species level identification, then what is the suitable type of the marker, which someone should know about. So, this is the important things in the DNA technology. Bioinformatics and data analysis is one of the very important things for compilation of the report. So, which include the analysis of the data using the different softwares, which are the used for making the final report. I am very, very satisfied with the job here working as a wildlife forensics expert, which provide you the scope for doing the all sorts of the things. Like if you want to do the R&D, so that is open in the wildlife forensic science. So it is still rapidly growing science. It is not a completely established science, but lot more need to be discovered in the forensic science. So for that you have to do the more and more research for doing the concise report writing. The repository, if for doing the wildlife forensic analysis, you have to compare the unknown case property with the known reference sample. So that known reference sample will come with the lot of effort. So you have to collect and keep the reference sample of all the protected species, those are listed in Wildlife Protection Act. So that is the very huge task. So that is the main challenge, and it provides scope for doing more and more R&D. I start my day with the coming to the lab and looking at the supervisory things in my laboratory. So I discuss with the researchers with their problems and their difficulties, what they are facing with the analysis, and then with the discussion and the major input, I try to solve their problem, and then try to do the analysis, and whatever report comes to me, I have to do the proper investigation and analysis of each and everything there, and then I compile the final report for the
reporting. So the one part of my routine in the wildlife forensic investigation. Then other than that, I run the several other research project also, which involve the conservation genetics as a tool. So I do the supervisory role with my to my students for doing the research in that particular theme and area. So that is how I spend my day in institute. So I hope I have given you the balanced information about the wildlife forensics, which will give you the proper knowledge if you are interested to take up your career in this field. So thank you very much.